Alright, this video is for a guy asked me a question on YouTube about an oil leak problem on his first-gen Yamaha Venture. And so I'm making this little quick video just to give him a idea of what I'm talking about here. Alright, I can't remember his name. It might be Mike. Well, I'll just refer to him as Mike anyway, because I can't remember his name. All right, so here's your this is your stator cover. All right, that's this cover, and notice the shifter lever passes through it right down here. All right, I'm pointing right down in through here. Okay, now this is the second cover back here. Is your forward bevel gear cover, and Mike, do you see these screws in that cover? I'm getting the garage all cramped up this morning, but I'm doing the best that I can here. These screws right here, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6 screws, hold that in place. The bottom screw on this guy, right down in here, that I'm pointing to, right down in here, the bottom screw for that cover is also a drain screw, okay? That's for draining that forward bevel gear housing of the small amount of oil that it holds. When you do an oil change, you're supposed to pull that and drain that so it gets fresh lube too. A lot of people don't when they drain the oil. When they do an oil swap, they don't. But some people do, all right? That bottom screw, this guy right down here, hidden behind the shift lever, that bottom screw also has a crush washer on the back side of it, a copper crush washer. And that copper crush washer has caused a lot of people issues in the oil leak. They'll seep oil if you don't replace that crush washer when you after you drain the oil. And I, you know, just the little bit that I know from what I'm reading about where your oil seep is coming from, it's possible that that's where it's at. So until I get more information from you, I would start there. I would start, remember what I told you in responding to your initial question, was to clean this area up real well. Clean the whole area up real well. If you don't have a power washer, use just take a can of spray carb cleaner and clean the whole area up underneath the bike. Just scrub it up real well, and then start it up. And then you have a better chance of identifying exactly where the oil is coming from. So we'll start your journey here as far as repairing your bike. These are magnificent bikes. Don't just give up on it yet. At least take a chance and see if you can figure out where your oil is coming from. So, okay, hope this helps.